Wentworth House was built in the late 1850s for the Duke of Wellington's brother-in-law. It later became Wentworth Golf Club. In the outbreak of the Second World War, Wentworth House and some of the surrounding houses were used by the military. What a lot of people don't know is what lies beneath the car park of Wentworth House. An extensive tunnel system built in the Second World War for the Home Forces GHQ. I make my way into the complex from the entrance on Wentworth Drive. After walking about 50 metres, I reach a door followed by an airlock. Going through this, you meet up with the main access tunnel. A 100 meters in length, this 12-foot diameter access tunnel was the center to the bunker, with 11 doorways either side that joined up with two parallel 20-foot diameter tunnels. These were lined with cast iron tunnel segments, also used on the London Underground tunnel network. The floor in these rooms has been removed from being gutted, most likely after the Second World War. You can see the underfloor ventilation channel in the centre. This would have fed air through ducting in the partition wall. The tunnels even had their own sump system, based at the east end of the tunnels. I made my way to the west end of the tunnels, going through yet another airlock. On the right of this partition, through this doorway, is the original plant room. For some unknown reason, it's been filled up with smashed up concrete. On my way to the second entrance, there's another airlock. After going through this, you reach a slope up. The second entrance was linked to Wentworth House by a set of stairs. Stairs have now been blocked off and a manhole cover has been put in its place.
Yesterday morning at 2:41 a.m. at General Eisenhower's headquarters, General Goebbels, the representative of the German High Command and of Grand Admiral Dönitz, the designated head of the German state.
After the Second World War, Wentworth House was handed back to the Golf Club and military use of the tunnels came to a close.
To the Allied Expeditionary Force and simultaneously to the Soviet High Command. We may allow ourselves a brief period of regret.
What will the future be of these tunnels? Will they ever be used again?
Japan will all have to
or will their existence just fade away?